Heyo, this is Kevin Tsunami Ishikane, and this is my journey. I was born and raised in Hawaii, and I was actually born on the smaller side. So I played a lot of sports, did like karate, baseball, you know, things that normal kids do. However, I was always the kid that got picked last. I was the last one on the fence all the time because I was small in stature. I actually wanted to prove myself that I'm just as good as everybody else. And so I've always had that chip on my shoulder, and that's what really drives me to make sure I succeed and I'm just as good as any other person out there. Well, my mom actually really believed in me quite a bit, and she would often tell my father, "Don't worry, he's gonna bloom." And my father would always reply to my mom, "When?"
I kept saying that for 3 years. I later found out he started working for an insurance company, and I said, "Insurance company?"
And as they were going through the interview process, then they mentioned, "We do things like family." And it immediately struck me, I'm like, wait, this is a corporate white collar job. What does that have to do with family? And so I'm like, okay, that's, you know, different, intriguing. And the way I thought about it is, well, what do I have to lose? Right? So if this doesn't work out, I'll just go back to school or go back to ABC stores. And since I started with AO, I've never turned back. All of the lights. Long time ago, to be on ATV, All Think Television, you have to write 6,000 AOP. Now the bar is pretty high, which is great because everybody's doing it, right? But back then it was 6,000. So my goal was to be on All Think TV every single week. Turn up the lights in here, baby. So that was a goal when I first started, to make a name for myself. And I remember at my first convention, and I got to meet Rick Altig for the first time. And so I approached him, I'm like, "Hey, you're Mr. Altig." And he looked down at me and he said, "You're Kevin Ishikane." And I'm like, "How does he know my name? Because I'm not even wearing my name tag, right?" And you know, he's greeting like hundreds of people at this conference. And he actually knew who I am, and I shook my hand. I put my hand out to shake his hand. And he looked at me and he said, "We don't shake hands here, friend, we hug." And I'm here hugging the CEO of our company. I'm like, oh my God, you know? And so that part about we do business like family, yeah, that was proven right there. I remember going to one of those executive meetings, and then we had to take notes and learn from all the great ones. And I actually left my glasses on there because it was just habit. It was a creature of habit. And I remember somebody saying like, "Ishikane, you should take off your glasses." And I remember Rick Altig stopping his speech. And he goes, "No, Kevin, you leave your glasses on. You look great." And so I got blessings from Rick. I'm like, okay, I'm gonna just leave it on. And so that was pretty awesome. I got special blessings from Blake. I wear my glasses. So that's been my signature thing. I just always have one. Sympathy, empathy, like caring about people, it's not something that can be taught. And when you look at families, you know, I don't look at them as AOP. I don't look at them as a sale. I don't look at them as, oh, if I sell this, I can buy that car I always wanted. You stop looking at people as money and things. People are people. I treat all the customers that I see like my family. What would you do for your brother? What would you do for your mom and dad? What would you do for your best friend? And so when you actually can like take that into perspective, funny thing is you kind of start to care a little bit more, and it's a transfer of feelings. So the more you care, the more you give, the more you will, the more they will enroll. Because on that family's darkest day of their life, I'm gonna be one of their best friends. Having a family, you know, it's very similar to like our customers. Like, it's not about you, it's about everybody else. And the same thing, like, you know, for all your managers out there, your teams, it's not about you, it's about your team, right? And my family is my team, you know, they're my support system. My priorities have shifted. It's everything that I do, it's for them. Back when I first started with AO, everything's all about me. I gotta be on All Think TV, I have to make a name for myself, right? And so that has changed. The focus of attention wasn't about me, you know? It was about taking care of my family and making sure that I can provide for them.
the stage that we're at right now, I'm very, very grateful and I'm blessed, you know, to have Kevin to be able to do what he does, helping other families on the way while he's trying to be the breadwinner for our family.
I'm very appreciative of the company for having him and giving him a great opportunity. I really thank them.
When I'm excited about my future, I am excited about renewals. I can't wait to retire. So I'm actually, well, you know, 15, 16 years, I'm 10 years vested, but if I were to retire right now, I'm a little bit too young to retire. That's going to be pretty selfish because I think I have a lot more mileage in my tank to give. And so I'm just going to keep going until I just can't. And even then, when I reach that milestone, maybe I'll just keep going even more, you know, until the doctor says I'm not able to work anymore. But I'm excited about the future. I'm excited about renewals. I'm excited about freedom. I'm excited about watching my kids grow, being there for all these important times in their lives, you know? You know, I'm excited about my family. And I'm very fortunate that I can be excited about that because I'm excited about our opportunity with AO.
So congratulations, son. Thank you, myself. And for mom too, she's smiling up above and saying, "Dad, he blossomed." And I have to agree, yes, he blossomed.